Blessed rise, guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Trish, and in this video I'm just gonna go through the process of me styling my hair with the Bohemian Reeves leave-in conditioner and the Morocco Method Blood of the Dragon styling gel. And these are my results. I washed my hair yesterday morning, which was Wednesday, and today it's Thursday morning, and this is after me bunning and stretching my hair. I did put it up in a pineapple after I took down the bun, and that's how I normally sleep, with a pineapple. So yeah, thank you so much for joining me, for holding space with me, for spending your time with me. You know, time is very precious. You know, time is something we cannot go back and retrieve. So whenever someone is giving you their time, you have to appreciate it. So bless, keep safe, be safe, live in love and harmony. Much love. Thank you. So this is freshly washed hair, no products. Shampoo with the Morocco Method shampoo bar, and I condition with the Curl Origin Double Moisture Deep Conditioner. So I'm gonna get ready to apply the leave-in conditioner by Bohemian Collection, and this is what it looks like. You see, it's that nice kind of jelly texture. It does not remind me of like a regular leave-in conditioner. So you see, I apply this to the section and I can start to see my curls, you know, forming and defining. The hair is looking shiny. And I kind of work it in and squeeze it into the section. I finger detangled in the shower, but I like to get a little bit in when I'm applying the leave-in conditioner. Now I'm getting ready to apply the gel, and I'm using the Morocco Method Blood of the Dragon styling gel. And that's what that looks like. You can tell that it's very light and runny, but look how it just really just go in and activate. At this point, I don't like to do too much of a finger detangling, so I'll just use my thumb to kind of smooth it through and form the curls and clump them together. I like to clump my curls in a big section. That way, when it dries, it's not too webby. I'm gonna apply a little more gel to that section. And this now I just smooth through. No disturbing of the curl, just smooth it over. I try to go up to the root, all the way down to the end, just smoothing it through and clumping it together. And that is it. I'm getting up to the crown up in here, it's like the hardest part of my hair to keep moisturized, to keep products in. It's the hardest part to define. It breaks. It requires a little bit more attention. So I just did three pumps of the leave-in, and I just repeat this all over my sections. Think I need a little bit more. I'm gonna do two more pumps because this is kind of a big section. I kind of let it clump up in those big sections by itself. It naturally does it. I can feel it. And I just encourage it to clump together because how runny that is. As I said, this section normally does not take well to any form of products, and it does perfect with this combo. The less puffy my hair is, when I'm styling, I know I'm gonna get good. So I mentioned in the video before this where I'm talking about the products that I'm using now that I cannot seal or add anything else, no oils, no butter to this combo. It just creates all kind of weird casts on my hair that creates frizz, so and it looks dull, and so I just use these two. I find that it's sufficient enough. And this is where you can see where it kind of separates by itself and clumps together.
Right.
So I am finished with one section of my hair, and this is the definition that I have on wet hair, and this is how I know it's gonna be good. So this is with product, without product. So I am finally finished. I'm almost out. Like, there's a little bit left in this, but I got 5 wash and go out of this bottle. So I used it 4 times before I came and did this review. So let me show you the back. It is still wet, but I'm gonna put it up in a bun because I have to go get ready for work. It is Wednesday morning. I was supposed to wash this hair from Sunday. I wanted to diffuse it a little, but time is against me. Actually gonna use the silk tie to Okay, so I put it up in the bun, but I was dripping, so I just put it up in this to kind of soak up a little bit of the water that is in my hair, and I'm gonna put it back up in the bun now. My hair is mostly dry. I think just some parts in here, it's just a little bit moist, so I kept in the bun up until about 1 o'clock, and then I took it out, and now it's around 5:30 or close to 6 in the evening, and these are the results. I mean, if I wanted this little nice bob thing, I normally, it's a little bit stiff now, but trust me, as the days go by, that will loosen up. And when the days go by, I can normally swoop it to one side. Now it looks very awkward and stiff. So I'll just wear it like this, and I'm good to go. So what I'm going to do tonight, I did not diffuse. This is all air dried and stretched, you know, in a bun while drying. I did not use any diffuser. As you saw this morning, I was like rushing to finish to get to work. So what I'm gonna do now, it's okay that, let me show you the top. So to stretch it a little more, I am going to put it back up into that bun for the remainder of the night, and I'll take it on tomorrow, and then from there I will pineapple. So I'll show you how it looks tomorrow, and then I'll just wrap this bit. That's so rude. See me making a video and making all that noise. try to smooth it and not disturb or mush my hair too much, but just smooth it out and just wrap it. And not too tight, because I'm going to bed and I don't want an edit. I like to use a silk tie for my hair. Have a blessed day, and we will chat it up. Until next time, be safe, you know, positive mind, positive outlook, just positivity and love, you know, that will carry us a very long way. So let's just keep on that energy.